Coming to you from Seattle tonight, where the roof at T-Mobile Park has been closed for comfort. We'll conclude the homestand with the first of two between the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and the Seattle Mariners. Major League Baseball on MLB Network coming up right after this. Mike Leake is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Mariners. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, you always like to begin the season on a good note. In his first start of the year, he did just that, picking up the win. There's nothing he'd like to do more than to get number two in this one here.
At the plate, Andrelton Simmons. And we are set for baseball here this evening. First pitch coming, here it is. Pitch to the plate is a sinker for a called strike one. And fellas, you take a look at these Seattle Mariners at the start of play here tonight. They haven't quite been able to get on track yet. They come in 2-4 over their first six games.
Yeah, Matty B. Hey, D-Wa, talk about a team that's scuffling right now. I had a chance to talk to the manager before the game. He's not happy. The players aren't happy.
Yeah, and just a malaise has kind of come over this clubhouse. We had a chance, like you said, to walk through it a little bit. The boys are not jumping around. This is a big game today.
And with that, let's take a look at the Angels starting lineup. D-Ro, what do you got in this lineup in the series opener?
Matty, I know I'm stating the obvious, but the middle of the order has to come through today. You got guys that are playing way above their pay grade on the periphery, and it's time for them to look and see the big boys do their job.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Pulls the string on that one. One strike. Now time to list the umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Jerry Hillsdale.
You know, D-Row, I think Jerry Hillsdale is a very good hitter's umpire. Doesn't give much on the edges. He's going to make you put the ball over the plate.
Oh, I love me some Jerry Hillsdale. You have to come over those 17 inches. He ain't giving you anything on the outside corner, and that's the way it should be.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and standing in the ever-dangerous Mike Trout. First pitch of the at-bat. Big swing and a miss at the knuckle curve, strike one. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Angels are gone in order. Nothing in the Angels half of the first. Seattle stepping up next. You're watching MLB Network. Taylor Cole, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, we're looking at a guy that knows how to pitch. Last year, his ERA was just under 3.5 for the season, and I would imagine going into the offseason, he's looking to better that, and hopefully he gets off to a good start. And we'll see if that starts in this one today.
Here's D. Gordon now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But a foul ball here, 0-1. So, fellas, this Angels team entering play here tonight. It's been a promising start to the new year as they've taken three of the first four contests.
Yeah, Matty, I've been really impressed with this team, especially on the recent road trip, the start to it. They're 3-1 after four games, playing really fundamentally sound baseball. From offense to defense, pitching, it's all coming together for this group.
And now a quick look at the Mariners' starting lineup in this one. Nero, give us what you have on this lineup as they start a new series.
Well, Matty, we know this is a pitcher's park. The numbers bear it out. Look for the managers to play a part in this one. Hopefully the guys listened in the hitters meeting. They're going to stay up the middle, big part of the yard. But when they get on, look for some wheels in motion, some execution, trying to manufacture some runs. I think that's how this lineup will play it out.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Line hard to center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
Hey, the leadoff man wasn't able to do his job, but the number two hitter came through right there with the single, setting the table for the big boys.
Edwin Encarnacion now, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. And he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. Smith stands at first with one out. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
We're seeing a good AB here from the three-hole hitter. If he can work a walk or pick up a hit here, he's going to put that cleanup guy in a really good position to do some damage in this first inning.
Line to the right side, and that's in there. Base hit. And that runner will go no further than second, as there are two aboard now.
Dan, after that base hit right there, he's got a six-game hitting streak going.
You know what? And this could lead him on to some bigger and better things right here. He's been swinging the bat pretty well, and he's been rewarded for it, as you talked about. Six-game hitting streak so far.
First pitch on its way. And he lays off there, 1-0.
That's a tough pitch to throw right there, that front door curveball. Just missed hitting that inside corner. That's a very difficult pitch. I'm not sure if he wanted to get that one down and away.
And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down. And they will hold that runner over at third, as he'll move up only 90 feet, but the bases are loaded with one away.
Well, this looked like it could have been a quick inning, get the first out, and then boom, 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 three singles. All of a sudden, they're loaded with one out.
Yeah, this is execution at its best right here. One out. He's still got double play in order. If he can make a pitch, he can get out of it. If he doesn't, crooked number goes up.
And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. Catch is made by Trout. Here comes the runner from third. And the run will score as the Mariners get off to a 1-0 lead.
Obviously, he's hoping for more up there with the bases loaded, but you can't be too upset with a sack fly.
So striding in, Ryan Healy, and the Mariners trying to make this first inning even bigger here. Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. A ball and no strikes.
That's how quick an inning can potentially get away from you out there. You get the first two outs pretty quick. Next guy gets on, and now you're staring the number four hole hitter in the face with a runner in scoring position.
1-0. Here it is. Count now a ball and a strike.
That fastball must have a little late life on it, because that was right in the wheelhouse, and he still wasn't able to get good wood on it.
Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
It's funny, that pitch, I can picture being in the box. That pitch looks so good to hit, and why does no one ever get to it? A good executed high fastball usually blows 9 out of 10 guys away.
Two down, runners at first and second. Two balls and two strikes to count to Ryan Healy. He's set. The 2-2. Fastball, and ooh, that ran in and drilled him.
Wow, I'm not sure if he was looking past this guy to the slugger coming up or just lost focus. But now the big bat steps to the plate with a great RBI opportunity.
Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager. And he puts it on the ground to second. Throw on the board takes care of him, and that ends the inning. Some more of the colorful characters here at the ballpark tonight. Don't touch that. Here's Justin Upton now. Past battles with Mike Lee. He's a 406 hitter. Two of those hits were for home runs. First pitch coming. Here it is. Sends that one out of play for strike one. No swing on the knuckle curve, even at 1-1. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball. Line shot to first, and there's one away. Digging in, Justin Bour. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Cut fastball taken for strike one. Easy take there on the sinker, well off the outside. And that's on the outside corner, one and two. Swing and a line drive. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Ready now, Zach Cozart. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. First offering on its way. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one. Sinker, and this one's over as well, nothing and two now. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Lays off, two and two now. Two out, nobody on. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Santana moves over. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Angels go down 1-2-3. It remains. Standing in, Omar Narvaez. First pitch of the at-bat. Strike one to start the at-bat. Now a swing and a miss, and things are not looking real promising here. Down 0-2. Bottom dropped out on him, and that's a strikeout. Lucroy has it. And he makes the throw to first. Nevarez is retired, and there's one away.
Here's how the Halos are going to line up on defense. And I'm locking in today on defensive extraordinaire David Fletcher. This is a guy that can beat you on the defensive side. He's got great hands, quick feet, great reaction time, loves turning the double play. They love having him out there.
And in the left field for a one-out hit.
Boy, after that base knock right there, D-Row, he extends his hitting streak to 7 games.
Yeah, and you can tell he's made some necessary adjustments at the plate. Anytime you're getting a knock every day of the week, you're doing things right. Keeping that front shoulder tough, staying inside the ball, not trying to do too much.
From the stretch. Drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. Cozart barehanded. One there, but wisely, no thought of a return throw, and the inning will continue.
That was kind of a high degree of difficulty play that time. You see the off-balance throw to second base, and he couldn't get a lot on it, but they did get the out.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Nope, pitch out. Nothing doing. The 1-0 home. Pops this one up. Cozart moving to his left, and that retires the side. One left for Seattle. We play two innings. It's 1-0. In is the catcher, Jonathan Lucroy. He's the number 7 hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first 6 guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. A ball and a strike. Hey. This is hit sharply to the left side. But right there to glove it is the shortstop for the first out. So there's the first out here in the Angels' third, and that'll bring in the left-handed hitting outfielder Cole Calhoun. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch lays off 1-0. Left it up in the zone, but it's a strike. 1-1. Now a pitch swung on and foul tipped right off the mask. It sounded like of the home plate umpire, and that cannot feel too good, I wouldn't imagine. Angel still looking for hit number one in the ballgame. Right side, but it's well foul. The 1-2. A bouncer to the left side. Throw on the first to get him. Score 5-3 on the putout, though it looked more like a 6-3 ground ball. Nevertheless, there are two away now. Coming to the plate now, David Fletcher. Two away in the inning, and Dan, it looks like this could be another 1-2-3 inning for him.
Yeah, he has really found a groove on the mound, and it's been impressive to watch. It'll be interesting to see how long he can keep this dominance up.
Hit on the ground to third. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Make it 9 straight here to start the ball game. We'll move on. Now at the plate, Edwin Encarnacion. He singled his last time up. First offering on its way. Here's a little chopper up the middle to his right, Fletcher. And quickly, there's one down to lead off the frame. One gone now in the Mariners' third inning, and that'll bring Domingo Santana into the batter's box next. First pitch coming, here it is. Line to the right side, but he'll barely have to move out there in right as he hauls this one in for the second out. Settling in now, Mitch Haniger picked up an RBI on a sac fly in his first appearance. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Liner towards second. Well, this will be pulled in out there at second base, and that'll be that. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. But they're on top 1-0. In now is Andrelton Simmons. Back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Nope. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game. Yeah, that looked like a strike, but let me tell you, when you're staring at a big zero in the hit column, getting a call like that to go your way can feel like a big victory.
Popped up, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. And another foul ball. Another 1-2 delivery. Lifted into the air to shallow center. Coming in is Smith. He tracks it down. A nice running play, and there's one away. Stepping up to the plate, Tommy La Stella. He flew out in his last at bat. First delivery to him on the way. This is swung on and popped up, crossing into foul territory now behind third. Here to take it is Seager, and that's out number two. So with two gone here in the fourth, let's check out our pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And you can see the top two speeds there, a 4-mile-an-hour differential for the two starters from 94 down to 90. Mike Trout is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one. Counts even to Trout, 1-1. Trout is really a rare talent in this sport, a true five-tool player, as they say, which means he can make an impact in a game at any time. Really a joy to watch, not someone you want to take your eye off of.
Yeah, this guy's
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Angels are gone in order. They're down 1-0. Next in at the plate is Ryan Healy. First offering on its way. There's the big breaking ball, and it's by him for a strike.
I mean, this is the classic case of ambush tactics at its finest, but this is getting a little ridiculous. I'd like to see some of these guys in the lineup work the count a little bit and find themselves on base and maybe drive this guy's pitch count up.
But no problem at first, and that's the first out. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And into bat next, the third baseman, Kyle Seager. First pitch coming. Here it is. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. Now here it comes. Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hold, 0-2. Popped him up. Cozart in foul ground. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Now at the plate, Omar Narvaez, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And they will still manage to get him at first. A spectacular all-around play, and the inning is over. Mariners. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I had a chance to discuss the state of the Angels offense with their manager between innings.
And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats.
They haven't had a single guy on base yet, so it's starting to feel a little desperate down here. But he said they've unfortunately just been faced with some really great pitching today. The key going forward is to find any way they can to get him out of his rhythm on the mound. Now, that may be a tall task, but they feel the little adjustments could lead to things turning around for them.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready with another 0-2. Lifted down the line in left. Santana will get there as he makes the catch in foul territory for the first out. Now at the plate, Justin Bour. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch of the at-bat. This one is launched. Look at this. And out of here. And I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed. It's a solo shot for Justin Bour. Second home run early in the year as the Angels are back even now at one run apiece.
No doubt an impressive home run, so we'll employ ShowTrack for a more in-depth look. 112 miles an hour was the exit velocity off the bat, so it's no wonder why it ended up having the impressive distance that it did.
Stepping in now, Zach Cozart. Tried to hold back, but this is popped up. Lee with a little do-it-yourself play, and there are two down. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that brings in Jonathan Lucroy. Sinker to open the AB in there for strike one. One run, just one hit, and no errors to this point for the Angels. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he pops him up here on 0-2 as this is drifting toward the right side of the infield. Encarnacion is there, and the side is retired. But the Angels are able to tie things up thanks to this solo home run. On to the bottom of the fifth, all even now at 1-1. Welcome back to T-Mobile Park in Seattle as we send it down to Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Mariners manager Scott Servais during the break about his team's offensive performance so far, and he told me that they have to find a way to be more patient at the plate. He said that although he's not against swinging at the first pitch, today they're doing so way too often and at well-executed pitches. As a result, six of their at-bats have resulted in outs on just the first pitch.
Thank you, Heidi. Shot toward right center. And that's into the gap and should be extra bases. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
Managers these days like to think of that nine-hole hitter as the second leadoff man, and he plays the role pretty well right here. Gets the leadoff double, and now he gives the real leadoff man a chance to bring him home.
First pitch of the at-bat. Try to bunt for a base hit here as he gets this one down. Kozar is up with it, and Gordon will beat this one out. It's a bunt single.
Hey, this has the makings of being a pretty big inning, D-Roll. Leadoff double, now a base hit, and all of a sudden we're looking at first and third.
Yeah, sometimes you wake up, you just get smacked in the mouth right here. He's going to have to start executing pitches. He cannot leave a ball over the heart of the plate right here. He's going to have damage on his hands.
Malik Smith, the next to hit, goes the other way with it as this is in the air down the line and left. And that's going to fall for a base hit. The cash in here as the run is in to score from third. And now time is called here as their pitching coach is going to pay a quick visit to the mound to discuss how they want to attack things here. Digging in now, Edwin Encarnacion. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Fouled off. Gordon over at second. Smith on at first with nobody out. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
Big spot right here. That's a great pitch to try and see if you could get him to fish outside the zone. He's still in the driver's seat right now.
His ball's down, and that could bring in a run. And no sense risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out.
Boy, there's a bullet base hit right there, but you have to hold there, D-Row, to make sure that gets down and isn't caught for a line drive double play.
Yeah, you have to play the game right there and respect the infield and respect the line drive. I know he wants to get a ribby for his buddy, but that's the way the game's played.
Into the box now, Domingo Santana. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. The run scores from second, and it's a 4-1 game. The relay. And now they'll at least get it out at third here as he's tagged out, but two runs are already in to score. Stepping in now is Mitch Haniger. Three runs already home and a potential fourth standing at third base. He's set. Here it comes. And he throws the fastball by him here. 0-1. Some stirring now in that Angel bullpen as it'll be both a lefty and a righty that start to get loose. High and deep to right center. On the move is Trout. And he makes the play, but this should extend their lead as the runner tags from third. And the runner from third crosses the plate.
Usually when you score a lot of runs in one inning, like this inning, you're doing a lot of things right. And how about this? A sac fly to drive in another run. They have to be happy with this.
Stepping up now, Ryan Healy comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Grounded weakly toward third. Throw on to first will finally retire him as the inning will draw to a close. So it's four runs on five base hits, no errors, and no one left on base. Five innings complete. It's the M's 5 and the Angels 1. Cole Calhoun will stand in now. He'll start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've been completely overmatched to this point. One hit through five innings. I mean, what else can you say about the pitching they faced other than it's been fantastic? We'll see if that continues as we approach the later inning.
One ball, no strikes to count. Good tailing action there. It's one and one. Calhoun swings the bat and throws from the left side and stands in at 5 foot 10 inches tall. He was an eighth round selection back in the 2010 first year player draft.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
Fouled away. The next 1-2 pitch. Popped him up. Nevarez over to his right. He's got it one away. Striding in, David Fletcher. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, and it looked like a sinker in his last AB that got him to roll over. Kind of similar situation right here. Similar stuff on the mound. Look for them to try and get him to do exactly the same thing as his last AB. He's got to fight to get it elevated just a little bit more.
Grounded down the third baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. And a liner foul into the seats down the right side. The 1-2. Another one sent foul. The 1-2. Gets him looking. Strike three.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Now a first pitch changeup here. Too far inside, it's 1-0. Swing and a line drive. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. Oh, and he misses it. Throw into second. Here's Tommy La Stella now, runner in scoring position with two gone. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1. Simmons at second with two down. 1-1 to Tommy La Stella. Hard hit ball to short. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt them after all as the inning is over. Angels strand one. They're down 5-1. Trevor Cahill enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. So striding forward now, Kyle Seager. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. The windup and the 0-1. Smoked on the ground up the middle. Simmons is there. And a rather easy first out. Now in the box, Omar Narvaez. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Here comes the first pitch. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
That's just a great pitch right there. Great execution. He just got that hitter to think that pitch was knee high. Nasty diving out of the zone.
Behind 0-2 now. We're in the sixth inning now of a 5-1 ball game. In the dirt, but swung on and missed. Lucroy gathers and he makes the throw to first. Nevarez is retired, two down now. Stepping in, Tim Beckham. He hit a two-bagger and later scored in his previous plate appearance.
Yeah, he jumped all over that first pitch last time up. Interested to see if he has the same approach this AB.
First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2.
Pretty late with the swing there. As a pitcher, you have to recognize that and keep coming in with the hard stuff until he proves he can hit it.
1-2, the count to the Mariners shortstop. Still 1-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Liner towards second. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Well, Dan, the sun goes down, and this guy lights up right here. That's his third knock of the night.
Talk about having a good night. Three hits, and, hey, he might have another at-bat or two before this one ends.
In now, D. Gordon, as the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Line drive to left. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Hey, after back-to-back two-out hits right now, this pitcher thought he was going to cruise through this inning, and now he's got traffic, and he's in jeopardy with a ball in the gap or a ball missed over the heart of the plate, a crooked number going on the board.
Standing in now, Malik Smith, as he swings and grounds it toward the hole. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. So it's no runs on two hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Here's the center fielder, Mike Trout, and he'll get us started in what's officially the back third of this one.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Hit hard to the right. Swinging a drive to left by Trout. This one's got a chance. Gone to lead off the inning. It's a solo home run here for Mike Trout. Second home run early in the year, and it's now a 5-2 game.
Wow, talk about a guy getting hot, right? Hits a bomb, hit one yesterday. Usually when he gets hot, he starts to hit them in bunches, and this could be the beginning of a very, very good hot streak.
Into the box, Justin Upton. As he'll swing and lift a fly ball to right center. Waiting on it is Haniger. One away. So digging in now, Justin Bour. One run in and one gone so far this inning.
In the last at bat, that breaking ball was really.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. 1-1 the count now. The 1-1. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Two runs, three hits, and no errors to this point for the Angels. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Wow, it just doesn't seem like he's being as aggressive as he was before he gave up that home run. Was throwing the ball great. Now it seems like he's a little bit more tentative throwing the ball across the plate.
Another try at 2-2. And it's fouled away.
Hey, he's got four foul balls in this AB right here. He's really making this pitcher grind for everything.
And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
And that's the second out. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Zach Cozart. 0-for-2 for him so far. He's flied out and popped out. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
Well, he's done a real nice job with that breaking ball in this start. That's not the first time he's locked a guy up with it.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
That wasn't a terrible pitch right there, but if he's going to execute and get this swing and a miss, he's going to have to get that ball a little bit further down, maybe even potentially bounce the next one.
The next 0-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Two out, nobody on. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled in a little foul. Drilled to the right side. On to Encarnacion at first, and that ends the inning. Angels do get one, however, on the Mike Trout home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's the M's 5 and the Angels 2. Digging in to try it again, Edwin Encarnacion. He reached on a single last time and later wound up scoring. First pitch on its way. Hit hard on the ground to first. Moore scoops it up, and he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. Digging in and looking for more, Domingo Santana. 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. First pitch of the at bat. A ball and no strikes.
Counts 1-0.
5-2 our score as we play inning number 7. Hit hard but short. Simmons has it. Simmons with a slide. He's out. But hold on here now. They quickly requested some time to take a look at the replay, and they may decide to challenge that out call.
Well, I think we're going to have to wait and see what the word is from the dugout, but here's another look at it. Wow. Tough to tell if he was out for certain from that angle. I can see why this was a really tough call for the umpire.
Now an indication from the dugout is that they will not challenge the call on the field, so the runner is indeed out. Stepping in now, Mitch Haniger, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. The windup and the 0-1. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. Swing and a miss as he chases one out of the zone for the third strike, and that's the third out of the inning. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. Digging in, Jonathan Lucroy. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Yeah, pretty impressive if you ask me. So many times you beat a sinker into the ground, you end up grounding out the third. You're running down to first base, and you're so upset at yourself. At least he got under the thing. He knows his bat plane is pretty decent.
And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Hey, excellent job right there, leading off the inning with a base hit. We got to keep this line moving. We cannot stop. Nobody can make an out. We have to find a way to put two men, maybe three men, put some pressure on this defense.
Lifted the other way down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball.
You can't allow this offense to get going right here. Leadoff man on doesn't kill us. Let's try and roll a double play right here. Let's execute a good pitch down and away. See if we can get a ground ball and rely on your defense a little bit.
Into the box, David Fletcher. He represents the potential tying run if he can launch one or find a way around the bases.
Yeah, Matt, I kind of doubt he's thinking about going yard, even though that would be the best result they could hope for. He's not a long ball threat, and he knows it, so he could just be looking for some way to keep that line moving.
Lucroy on second, Calhoun at first with no outs. Pitch is popped up, brings it in, standing inside the coach's box for out number one. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and standing in one of the best two-strike hitters in baseball, Andrelton Simmons. Gordon is up with it. There's one. On to Encarnacion, but it's too late to get them both.
Great job of hustle there by the base runner. That looked like an easy inning-ending double play. Now runners at first and third with two outs.
Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. And a good idea to hold off on that swing. It's ball one. Ready with the one and one. That's in there on the outer half. One and two now. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Angels strand a couple. They trail 5-2. At the plate, Ryan Healy, 0 for 2 for him to. First pitch of the at bat. Chopped toward the second baseman. Fletcher charging in on it. One away. So stepping in, Kyle Seager. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. We're in the eighth inning now of a 5-2 ball game. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. Throw on to first, and Cahill's looking sharp here. Two away. Next for Seattle, Omar Narvaez. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Lays off the sinker here, a ball and a strike. Two out, nobody on. The 1-2. Gets him swinging. He struck him out. Mariners are down in order. They're still out in front, 5-2. Digging in, Mike Trout. And his guys need him to get things started here in the top half of the ninth. Pitch number 100 on its way. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike.
Hey, in this day and age where everybody's watching the pitch count, that was pitch number 100 in the ninth inning, but he still looks awfully impressive on the mound.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Lifted in the air to straightaway left. Santana has a read on it. One down. So here's the cleanup hitter, Justin Upton. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. First pitch on its way to Upton. In there for strike one, 0-1. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. The 1-1. One ball and two strikes to count. The 1-2. Is at the knees and called strike three.
Well, I'm glad we get another look at that beauty of a pitch right there. You can't spot a sinker in a better location, because even if you do get the bat on the ball, there's not a whole lot you can do with that. Textbook sinker.
In now, Justin Bour. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Now the pitch. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Now this will rattle up against the wall. The throw into second. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
Let's slow this one down and take another look. Great camera angle here. Looking straight down the left field line. You see him take that inside route to the ball. His hands stay back. And he goes oppo to find himself at second.
Now here comes the Mariners skipper out to the mound, and that means that's going to do it for starter Mike Leake. So he'll head for the showers as he stands to win this one if the bullpen can find a way to protect a 3-run lead. Into the box now, Zach Cozart. One ball, no strikes to count. Bour stands at second with two gone. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But it bends just foul into the second deck. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Taken, called strike two. And now they're down to their final strike tonight. Now this crowd of just over 21,000 are on their feet. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Wow, you don't see a closer finish better than that very often. Only needed four pitches to slam the door in the face and salt this game away for his guys.
5-2, the final score tonight. The Seattle Mariners used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Mike Leake takes the win on the mound, his second of the year, as he finished just one out shy of 9 complete innings. So that just about does it. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.